Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Let us go into the house of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. It's just gates with thanksgiving. It's just heart with praise.
In those days came John the Baptist, preaching in the wilderness of Judea, and saying, Repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
En aquellos días, Juan el Bautista se presentó predicando en el desierto de Judea, y decía, Arrepiéntanse, porque el reino de los cielos se ha acercado.
That died.
I indeed baptize you with water unto repentance. But he that cometh after me is mightier than I, whose shoe I am not worthy to bear. He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire, whose fan is in his hand, and he will thoroughly purge his floor and gather his wheat into the garner. But he will burn up the chaff with unquenchable fire. Then cometh Jesus from Galilee to Jordan unto John to be baptized in him. But John forbade him, saying, I have need to be baptized of thee, and comest thou to me? And Jesus answering said unto him, Suffer it to be so now, for thus it becometh us to fulfill all righteousness. Then he suffered him. And Jesus, when he was baptized, went up straightway out of the water, and lo, the heavens were opened unto him. And he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove, and lighting upon him. And lo, a voice from heaven, saying, This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased.
A decir verdad, yo los bautizo en agua en señal de arrepentimiento. Pero el que viene después de mí, de quien no soy digno de llevar su calzado, es más poderoso que yo. Él los bautizará en Espíritu Santo y fuego. Ya tiene el bieldo en la mano, de modo que limpiará su era, recogerá su trigo en el granero y quemará la paja, un fuego que nunca se apagará. Jesús fue a Galilea al Jordán, donde estaba Juan para ser bautizado con él. Pero Juan se lo oponía diciendo, Yo necesito ser bautizado por ti, y tú vienes a mí. Jesús le respondió, Por ahora déjalo así, porque conviene que cumplamos toda justicia. Entonces Juan aceptó. Después de ser bautizado, Jesús salió del agua. Entonces los cielos se abrieron y él vio al Espíritu de Dios que descendía como paloma y se posaba sobre él. Desde los cielos se oyó entonces una voz que decía, Este es el Hijo amado en quien me complazco.
Then was Jesus led up of the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. And when he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, he was afterward a hunger. And when the tempter came to him, he said, If thou be the Son of God, command these stones to be made bread. But he answered and said, It is written, Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. Then the devil taketh him up into the holy city, and sitteth him on the pinnacle of the temple, and saith unto him, If thou be the Son of God, cast thyself down, for it is written, He shall give his angels charge concerning thee, and in their hands they shall bear thee up, lest at any time thou dash thy foot against a stone. Jesus said unto him, It is written again, Thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. Again, the devil taketh him up into an exceeding high mountain, and showeth him all the kingdoms of the world, and the glory of them, and saith unto him, All these things will I give thee, if thou would fall down and worship me. Then saith Jesus unto him, Get thee hence, Satan, for it is written, Thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve.
Luego Jesús fue llevado por el Espíritu al desierto para ser tentado por el diablo. Después de haber ayunado 40 días y 40 noches, tuvo hambre. El tentador se le acercó y le dijo, Si eres hijo de Dios, di que estas piedras se conviertan en pan. Jesús respondió, Escrito está, no solo de pan vive el hombre, sino de toda palabra que sale de la boca de Dios. Entonces el diablo le llevó a la santa ciudad, lo puso sobre la parte más alta del templo y le dijo, Si eres hijo de Dios, lánzate hacia abajo, porque escrito está: a los ángeles mandará alrededor de ti y también en sus manos te sostendrán, para que no tropieces con piedra alguna. Jesús le dijo: también escrito está: no tentarás al Señor tu Dios. De nuevo, el diablo lo llevó a un monte muy alto. Allí le mostró todos los reinos del mundo y sus riquezas. Y le dijo: todo esto te daré si te arrodillas delante de mí y me adoras. Entonces Jesús le dijo: vete, Satanás, porque escrito está: el Señor tu Dios adorarás y a Él solo servirás.
The King of Kings, the Savior of the world, now hangs on a tree. Soon, the world will know that I am King, that I am the only Lord. I have taken all power from the one who is proclaimed Lord. No! No! This can't be happening! I can't believe it!
And it came to pass, when Jesus had finished all these sayings, he said unto his disciples, ye know that after 2 days is the feast of the Passover, and the Son of Man is to be betrayed and crucified. Then assembled together the chief priests and the scribes and the elders of the people unto the palace of the high priest, whose name is Caiaphas, and consulted that they might take Jesus by subtlety and kill him. But they said, not on the feast day, lest there be an uproar among the people. Now when Jesus was in Bethany, in the house of Simon the leper, there came unto him a woman having an alabaster box of very precious ointment, and poured it on his head as he sat at meat. Then one of the 12, called Judas Iscariot, went unto the chief priests, and said unto them, what will you give me, and I will deliver him unto you? And they covenanted with him for 30 pieces of silver. And from that time he sought opportunity to betray him.
Cuando Jesús terminó de decir todo esto, dijo a sus discípulos, como ustedes saben, dentro de 2 días se celebrará la Pascua, y el Hijo del Hombre será entregado para ser crucificado. Entonces los principales sacerdotes, los escribas y los ancianos del pueblo se reunieron en el patio de Caifás, el sumo sacerdote, y se confabularon para aprehender con engaños a Jesús y matarlo. Pero decían, que no sea durante la fiesta, porque no se alborote el pueblo. Mientras Jesús estaba en Betania, en casa de Simón el leproso, se le acercó una mujer. Llevaba un vaso de alabastro con un perfume muy caro, que derramó sobre la cabeza de Jesús mientras él estaba sentado en la mesa. Entonces Judas Iscariote, que era uno de los 12, fue a ver a los principales sacerdotes y les dijo, ¿cuánto me darían si les entrego a Jesús? Y ellos le asignaron 30 piezas de plata. Desde entonces, Judas buscaba el mejor momento de entregar a Jesús.
Pain. Don't take it lightly, what I've done, why is it easy? But it was worth it. It wasn't easy.
Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus into the common hall and gathered unto him the whole band of soldiers. And they stripped him and put on him a scarlet robe. And when they had plaited a crown of thorns, they put it upon his head and a reed in his right hand. And they bowed the knee before him and mocked him, saying, Hail, King of the Jews. And they spat upon him, and took the reed, and smote him on the head. And after that, they mocked him. They took the robe off from him, and put his own raiment on him, and led him away to crucify him. And they crucified him, and parted his garments, casting lots, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet. They parted my garments among them, and upon my vesture did they cast lots. And those things that were done, they feared greatly, saying, Truly, this was the Son of God. And many women were there beholding afar off, which followed Jesus from Galilee, ministering unto him. Among which was Mary Magdalene, and Mary the mother of James, and Joseph, and the mother of Zebedee's children.
Los soldados del gobernador llevaron a Jesús al pretorio y alrededor de él reunieron a toda la compañía. Luego lo desnudaron, le echaron encima un manto escarlata. Sobre la cabeza le pusieron una corona tejida de espinas y en el mano derecha le pusieron una caña. Entonces se arrodillaron delante de él y burlonamente le decían, Salve, reino de los judíos. Además, le escupían y con una caña le golpeaban la cabeza. Después de burlarse de él, le quitaron el manto, le pusieron sus vestidos y lo llevaron para crucificarlo. Después que lo crucificaron, echaron suerte para repartirse sus vestidos. Con lo que se cumplió lo dicho por el profeta. Se repartieron mis vestidos y sobre mi ropa echaron suertes. Al ver el terremoto y las cosas que habían sucedido, el centurión y los que estaban en él custodiando a Jesús se llenaron de miedo y dijeron, En verdad este era el Hijo de Dios. Muchas mujeres que desde Galilea habían seguido a Jesús para servirlo estaban allí mirando de lejos. Entre ellas estaban María Magdalena, María, la madre de Jacobo y de José. Y la madre de los hijos de Zebedeo.
He gave me new life, and I will forever serve him. He forgave me for all of my sins, and I know that he is truly the Son of God. Don't weep, for his mission to save the earth has been accomplished.
Mm-hmm. You have the power and the authority to change your situation. Hallelujah. Don't be
way too fast. But I knew, as he had often said, that the Savior of the world would suffer greatly. The comfort for me was the saving, redeeming, and deliverance of many souls. He suffered, he bled, and he died. But all glory, he rose again. One day I was walking to the well as I always did, to get water. And as I came to the well, there was a man sitting, a Jewish man. And he asked me for a drink of water. He offered me a drink from a well that never runs dry. I didn't understand what he meant, but he began to tell me everything that I thought I had hidden, all about myself. As I listened to him, I wondered, how did he know all the men that I had been with, all the places that I had sought for love and found none? As he began to speak, my eyes were open and I realized I could be free, free, free. Now I can see him, myself, and see him and all that he has done for me. Now I must run and tell everybody.
I was raised in a home where I was taught to put God first and everything would fall into place. But I didn't need God. I had the job, I had the money, I had everything that I needed to satisfy me. The more that I went through life, I realized I did need Jesus. I needed him to show me how to live, how to be everything that he has called me to be. Once he introduced himself to me, I was no longer bound by life and its struggles and its hurts and its pains. He led me to live free and break through. Now I'm leaving my issues at the cross and walking forward in God.
For the majority of my life, I was trying to fill this void. I was searching here, there, and just everywhere. I thought I found it. In drugs, alcohol, but I ain't fine. Not there, not there. Glory be to God. I found him, found what I was looking for in Jesus. He put me right here on this street. Glory to God. By the renewing of my mind, and the Holy Spirit, I found God. He put my feet on solid ground. Thank you, too.
Don't have much to bring. option.